Welcome back, everybody. Just Watch Movies here for another review of Purge 2 Anarchy. If you guys checked out my Purge 1 review, I told you guys I would have a special guest for my Purge 2 review. I'm excited today to have my special guest come on. We just kind of met the other day and started talking and wanted to collaborate for this review. He's a really awesome guy. His name is Michael Chu. I don't know if I pronounced your name, last name correctly. I'm sorry, dude. Really humble guy, really nice guy, and he's going to give his thoughts first on Purge 2 Anarchy, and then I'm going to jump in after him and give my review of Purge 2 Anarchy. So, Michael, take it away.
What's up, guys? Michael here, bringing you another video today, except I'm not on my channel. Thank you, Justin, for having me on yours. I'm very excited to talk about the Purge Anarchy with you. Let's just dive right in. Purge Anarchy stars Frank Grillo, and the movie is basically kind of similar to the first one in a way, but not. It's about this man, Frank Grillo, compelled by vengeance to go out on Purge Night and hunt this man down because he hurt his loved one very dear. Without getting too spoilery, that's the basis of it. And I have to say, I do enjoy the first Purge movie. I enjoy the series of movies. And this one is a step up for me. Purge 2 is a step up from the first one because we get this whole new dynamic environment that we didn't get in the Purge 1. Because in the Purge 1, we were kind of in like an isolated area. We were just in the house, and now we're out in the city. Anything could happen. There's crazy people running around everywhere. So it offers up a whole new interesting playing field for our main characters trying to survive this night. And a problem that I kind of have with this, it's not really a problem, it's more of a problem with the marketing for this movie when it came out, is that they market this like a horror movie. Now, in my opinion, this isn't really a horror movie. It's kind of like a thriller, per se, because there's not many scares in it. It doesn't try to be scary at any point, really, aside from a few mindless jump scares. It doesn't really go to that point. It feels more Terminator-esque in a lot of scenes, or that of another action movie rather than a horror movie. It feels more akin to The Guest rather than Evil Dead or something scary, you know? So if you're in it for a horror movie, I would not suggest this movie to you, but if you're in it for a kind of like a dynamic, cool thriller action movie, this is the movie for you. The movie is pushed forward drastically because of Frank Grillo. He is so badass in his role as this kind of stoic, cold-hearted, menacing hero, or anti-hero, whatever you want to call him, who is kind of just thrust into this situation, or he doesn't want to get involved and help anybody, but he kind of becomes a hero along the way, along his journey for revenge. And the plot is kind of predictable, you know, it has a lot of, you know, generic moments, but there are also some moments that are very memorable. Like, there is a scene in an apartment that I won't get too into, but it involves a bunch of supporting characters, and it's kind of crazy. But that's what these movies are for, just to show the crazy side of human nature and how, you know, we go to extreme lengths just to make ourselves feel better on this one night. I also liked how it kind of showed what happens in other rich people, you know? Rich people during the Purge night, they don't go out, so what do, you know? So we got to see a little bit of that in this film, and they made it seem like with the trailers for election year that we're going to see more of that in the following film, which comes out this week. Like I said, very, very fun movie. The ending is all over the place. The last 20 minutes of it is freaking ridiculous, but it kind of went in a different direction than I expected, which is good. There were no loose ends at the end of it. A lot of things wrong with this movie. You know, it's not a technically sound movie. The directing is kind of lazy, to be honest with you. Lots of wide shots. But other than that, you know what, there's not really much to say, except if you're in it for a good time, you can't really go wrong with this. It's a mindless movie. You could have lots of fun watching it. Frank Grillo's good in it. Like I said, the action's good in it. There are a bunch of memorable scenes, or a couple really, really memorable scenes, one involving a subway, one involving an apartment complex, like I said earlier. You know what? So we're going to end it right here, guys. I'm going to give Purge Anarchy a 6.25 out of 10. Take it away, Justin.
Thank you, Michael, for being on my channel to discuss Purge 2 Anarchy. Purge 2 Anarchy, I love this movie. It is more fun than the Purge movie. It is what I wanted the Purge movie to be like. The Purge felt so isolated and had such a cool concept. And Purge 2 is exactly what I wanted the first one to be like. They took this awesome idea. It's not awesome. I would never want this to happen to anybody. But this cool concept of 12 hours, you can do what you want. There's so much that everybody is doing in the world. And now you get to see it. You get to see the streets, everybody going crazy, and that's what I loved about The Purge 2 is that it was open. There was so much going on. It was a cliche at times, the characters were cliche, but I enjoyed seeing the open world of everybody causing mayhem. I don't know, I just, maybe crazy. I'm sure Donald Trump would try to do that sometime. But I thought this movie was, you know, the mayhem was crazy, the violence was crazy. Overall, I really enjoyed this film because the Purge felt so smaller in a big world, a big futuristic world where these things is actually happening. And The Purge 2 is not the whole entire United States of America. It's a little bit bigger, but we get to see that just not, you know, a street full of people are trying to do stuff on The Purge. Now we get to see like a whole city full of people, what they do on The Purge Day. And I just like The Purge 2 Anarchy. It's not the best film ever made. It is certainly not the worst film ever made, but it is a fun, enjoyable horror film that I feel like, you know, bogged down with a lot of supernatural films. The Purge 2 felt really refreshed and good. So I'm gonna go ahead and give The Purge 2 Anarchy a B+. This is Just Watch Movies and Michael Chu with a review of The Purge 2 Anarchy. What did you guys think of The Purge 2 Anarchy? Did you like The Purge 1 more than the second one, or you like the second one more than the first one? Are you guys excited for the third one, election year? And then the fourth one next year, or the fifth one the year after that, and the sixth one after that? So this is Just Watch Movies. Once again, thank you for my guest for being on my channel. I'll put the link down below for his channel. Down the road, I think maybe next week, we are going to try to do a interview where he's going to interview me about my channel and stuff on his channel. So go over there, give him a like, subscribe to his channel, tell him Justin sent you. Thank you guys for watching. Remember to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to Just Watch Movies. It means a lot. Thank you guys for always watching, and you stay classy, YouTube.